Hi everyone, it's Felix Sandman here for Home for Christmas, and I'm with
Stian, also from Home for Christmas.
We're here today because Stian, I think Christmas is all about love.
Oh yeah,
don't you think?
It is the love season.
It's the love season, the love holiday, and that's why we're here, because we're gonna react to some pretty interesting love and dating stories.
Yeah, some wild ones. Some
yes. Let's get to it.
Yeah, let's
dive in. Are you
ready,
Stian? Nice.
Dive in. Went on a date with a girl who said she was a sushi chef. All right, sounds good. Everything went better than expected, except for the part where she neglected to tell me that she only worked half time as a sushi chef, and the rest of the time she was a dominatrix.
I mean, to me, it sounds like an interesting person.
It definitely is an interesting person.
I mean, sushi chef and a dominatrix. I think also, I don't know if this is just in my weird mind, but you can combine those two, right? I mean, because a lot of people use this, like, sushi in intimate moments. So maybe you can combine those two. But I mean, for me, dominatrix, it just sounds scary, you know? Like, yeah. I don't even, like, know really what it really is. I kind of know, but, like, not, like, really in detail what it is, but it just scares me. Okay, immediately after the date, I spent 20 minutes complaining via WhatsApp about how bad the date was. I thought I was talking to my friend with the same name as my date. It was my date and not my friend.
Oh,
that sucks.
Wow.
Maybe the date wanted to start to ask questions to get the person to
problem?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, right?
how was he looking?
That's awful.
Yeah, was he a good looking dude? No, he was horrible.
I mean, if you have a friend that has the same name, I mean, I would be extra cautious to just really check if it's the right person, right?
Yeah, I would do a little half hour of admin in my contacts book.
Yeah.
Like, just kind of just put a prefix or something like Maria, friend, and not
Maria,
my Spanish date.
Yeah.
I was going on my first date with someone I had met online. We had been talking a bit for about 2 weeks before we met. We went to dinner on our date. He wasn't super talkative, and it was mildly awkward. Then when he was dropping me off, I gave him a hug goodnight, and he takes this opportunity to whisper in my ear, "I love you." I didn't know what to do, so I laughed awkwardly, assuming he was joking. He wasn't.
Okay.
That is horrible.
That's horrible. That's crossing the line. I mean, you can't say that. I mean, that's creepy. That's just creepy. If I heard that, like, if he were to whisper in my ear, I wouldn't, like, I would just think he's creepy and, like, he's gonna kill me, you know?
Yeah, no, that is a dead giveaway of a serial killer. Yeah.
That must have been really awkward. I don't know what I would have done if that happened to me, but I would definitely get out the car.
Yeah, I would have brought out the pepper spray.
Yeah, like that. Yeah, that's
just
scary.
No questions asked.
Yeah.
I asked a coworker out for dinner. Took her out that night to a nice restaurant. We had a few drinks at the restaurant. She said she wasn't feeling well. Apparently, she was on some medicine that made alcohol twice as powerful, and she was a total lightweight. I offered to take her home, and she ended up puking in my brand new car. We ended up dating for over 2 years after that night. Well, this is kind of interesting, because I think that if you can look at a person when that person is on her or his worst, like puking or just having a really
still
say like, "God damn, you're beautiful."
That's love.
Yeah, you like every first date, you start with some puking. This is like, this is me on my worst.
Yeah, Because you love me now? Then you've seen everything, right? Because yeah. So that you can live together and do all that stuff.
Do you want this?
I think this is really cute. Last one. Match.com. It's a dating site. Paired my mom with my dad. They'd been divorced for 10 years at this point. That's awkward.
That is amazing. Maybe this was the last thing that was needed to spark the flame again. A machine and algorithms. To
wow.
Tell them they were a match.
Maybe they got married again.
Maybe.
Maybe.
I want to hear the end of this story.
All right. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. Hope you enjoyed and learned something about dating. Hope we gave you some good advice or tips. I don't know.
Yeah, be aware of the air whisperers out there.
That's scary.
And have a blast this Christmas. And whatever you do, you got to see Home for Christmas Season 2 on Netflix. I think that's the best tip I can.
Yeah. That's some great dating advice. Watch Home for Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.